There is a large problem with homelessness in Philadelphia. In the most recent point in time count that was done, there were over 6,000 homeless. That count does not include people who may be sleeping on a couch someplace, who may be with relatives. To be homeless can take them into depths of despair, of loneliness, trying to figure out what's going to happen next, not only where am I going to stay, what am I going to eat, where am I going to find a bathroom, any number of different things that are much more difficult when you don't have that place to live, that place to stay. One of the things that I warn people about is not to stereotype them, not to assume a lot of things, because each homeless individual has their own story. Sure, they may have made a number of wrong choices, and that led to further problems. But who of us hasn't made a wrong choice at some time or another? To climb back up, to have a way to begin putting your life back together. Some of them may be way beyond that. They need somebody to come alongside them. Sometimes, unfortunately, we can't even get them to come in our doors. Sometimes it's somebody that's been out on the street for so long, and because of their mental health problems, because they are still in the midst of wanting to continue to use drugs, that we can't convince them to come in. But we keep trying.
So we've got this limit to how far we'll go for someone else. People are not really willing to give up but so much. And some people just want you to recognize their humanity. And oftentimes, we just won't do it. We just want to keep going, and we want our day to run smooth. We don't want to get caught up in other people's lives.
I believe that we are limited as a society by the least and the last, meaning if we forget these people, walk over them, or pretend that they don't exist, as a society and particularly as a city, we are all called to love these folks. Are we willing to take the time and condescend and say, how did this happen? To answer the call to love our neighbors, to give them a face, to give them a name, to understand their stories. Again, I don't believe any of them woke up that morning and said, I think I'll be homeless. How did they get there?
Those who are encountering homelessness are at their literal lowest point in their life. This is the moment that they need the most help, they need the most love, and they need the most care. Sunday Breakfast Rescue Mission is the largest emergency shelter in the city. Every night, up to 240 people can actually spend the night with us at this location. During the winter, that can actually grow above that number because we have overflow cots. One of our mottos is that we serve everyone no matter what, always. So we really won't turn someone away. We serve three meals a day, every single day of the year. Even though we're called Sunday Breakfast Rescue Mission, we actually serve breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day of the week.
Takes a lot of food to serve three meals a day, 7 days a week. We're serving over 400 meals a day here at the Mission. We're the largest indoor feeder of the homeless in Center City, Philadelphia. So we really depend upon the help of donations. And there are a number of people, a number of organizations that have been great about doing food collections for us.
Some people just need you to share that you care. It's a hard world when you live in a place where nobody cares. And I think if we could just learn how to love on one another, everybody has had a moment when they needed to be encouraged. And you know what? People come in daily, every day, and every day they're just looking for some love. Just somebody, just encourage me a little bit. You see, the humanity part, we don't see them as people unless we know them by name, right? And then they'll write that name on you, and then you'll have compassion for that person because they become somebody to you. And when they give you that name, then this person becomes alive.